We talked about that the reality of the kingdom of God drawing near, the good news is Jesus himself. Because Jesus is God. We then get to hear about Jesus traveling last week, teaching with authority, healing people, casting out demons, and today we get a continuation, all from the same story of the beginning of Jesus' ministry. Jesus heals Peter's mother. People in the town hear about this healing, and so they bring everybody who is sick, or has a demon, or is hurt, or whatever it might be, to come to Jesus. They don't care who Jesus is. They don't know who Jesus is. They just know that if they come there, he will heal that person or themselves. That is what they are thinking. That's what we would all think. If someone's sick in our family, someone can make them better, we would go there. We wouldn't care so much who they were. One of the things that we talked about was not only do we have to do the work of the church, be kind and love our neighbors, serve one another, love God with all our heart, mind, soul, body, and all that we have, but that we have to take time to remember what the main mission is. And that's what Jesus tells us today. Jesus gives us the example that we have to take time to mend ourselves. That when we pour out ourselves in service and love of others, we have to take time then to rest and pray and worship and study and take time to recover ourselves. Because if we only put out, if we only give out, if we only lay ourselves out, then we will become burnt out. And God gives us those tools. God allows us and gives us the privilege and the honor to come to places like this to hear beautiful music, to come to places to worship, to hear the word of God, to come places to study together, to fellowship and have fun together, and then also to serve together. That is what it means to be the body of Christ and disciples of Jesus, to be one together in Christ. But it's easy to get distracted. It's easy only to focus on doing the nice things. It's easy to tire ourselves out when we're only doing the good work. And we forget to pray and worship and recover and continue growing in our relationship with God and each other. It's also distracting because we can focus on the message of doing good things, but we forget that Jesus came not only to serve, but to share the good news of God. That the kingdom has come near. We see in this text that Jesus goes off and prays. The disciples come and say, everybody's looking for you. Let's go back into town and you can heal everybody else. Jesus says, that's not the main message. The main mission for Jesus is to go and proclaim the good news of God. To tell others about what God is doing. To tell others that God has broken into the world through Jesus Christ. So we got to keep two things in balance, Jesus tells us. We not only serve, but we also share. We share the good news with others. We tell people why it is that we serve, through our actions and through our words. That this is an expression of our faith and our relationship with God and with each other. So I just want to kind of wrap that up today. As we've been exploring what Jesus is doing in the beginning of his ministry. That the mission work of healing and teaching is an outpouring from the reality that Jesus is God. That Jesus came into this world to be with us. To experience all that life has to give, the bad and the good, to know what it is to be a human being, to know what it is to have friends and loved ones, to know what it is to lose friends and loved ones, and to know what it is to be persecuted and rejected, and to know what it is to even die. We have a God who knows what it is to be one of us, the good and the bad of life. We know we have a God who is with us. Always, right here, in this place, right now. He was with us here and everywhere we go. A God who invites us to serve together as the body, but invites invites us also to take time for prayer and rest as the body as well. So I want to thank you all again for being here. Thank you for sharing your beautiful music as a way to help us rejuvenate so that we can then go out into this world, knowing that God has won our salvation for us, knowing that God has chosen us as God's people, knowing that God has accepted us, that we don't have to accept Him. Because Jesus came to us. God comes to us. And that is our opportunity to give thanks. So we thank God in our worship, we thank God in our prayers, we thank God in proclaiming through music, we thank God that God is with us now and always. Amen?
Amen.